Shalom, shalom, man. This is on the New York Post. China says new hypersonic missile, a blow to U.S. strategic security. So they're flexing, man. Here we go. China is putting the U.S. on blast following the launch of a hypersonic missile into orbit, ridiculing America's sense of strategic security. China's putting the U.S. on blast. So Moab, now this reminds you of the scriptures say the weak, tell the weak that I am strong, just paraphrasing. At one time, these nations, they fear Babylon the Great because of their firepower, you know? But now, these nations, they have the same nuclear capabilities. They have the same weapons, even better. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, Moab really feels in his heart, you know, that once Babylon the Great falls, you know, and be destroyed, they're going to be the next ruling power. No, man. But it's just to show you, man, that world war is ahead. World War III, these prophecies will be fulfilled, man. Okay? Let's read 2 Ezra 16 and 1. Woe be unto thee, Babylon and Asia. See that? Woe be unto thee, Egypt and Syria. Gird up yourselves with cloths of sack and hair. Bewail your children and be sorry, for your destruction is at hand. A sword is set upon you, and who may turn it back? A fire set among you, and who may quench it? Plagues are sent unto you. Plagues are sent unto you, and what he that may drive them away? May and man drive away a hungry lion in the wood, or may anyone quench the fire and stubble when it had begun to burn, man. You understand? So Moab really feels, you know, they're feeling themselves right now. All these other nations, you know, they're feeling themselves. World War III is ahead. You know, these nations, they ain't afraid of Babylon the Great no more, America. They look down at America now. It's a laughing stock now, you know? So it's going to go down, man. They really think, no. Let's read. Psalm 60 and 8. Moab is my wash pot. You see what the Lord said, Moab? Moab is my wash pot. Over Edom will I cast out my shoe. Philistia, triumph thou because of me. Okay? Come on now. Daniel 7 and 18, man. All you other nations are living in a dream, you know? Living in the dream, because the next rulers on the planet Earth is finally going to be the Israelites. Okay? The saints of the Most High. Why? Because we were given this. This was our blessing from the beginning. You know? Daniel 7 and 18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever. No, just a couple of years. Forever, man. Even forever. And ever. That's eternity, man. We're going to finally rule in harmony and righteousness, man. No more Moab and all these nasty different nation heathens. Daniel 2 and 44. And in the days of these kings shall the God of heaven, the Most High Yahweh, set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. Do you hear that, Moab? The Israelites, the saints of the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahshua, is going to rule the planet Earth in righteousness forever. Okay, we got next, man. Shalom, the Bukharim Shaw, Yasharala. All praises to Yahweh Shem Yahshai, the Wadab Yahweh Shem Yahshai. Shalom, brothers. Moab is in vain.